On yet another day of one breaking story after another in the Russian investigation, there is yet more tonight. Late reporting in the New York Times and a phone call that two people briefed on it tell the Times the president made to then FBI Director Comey. It is, in many ways, the backstory to the video you're looking at right now. You see Director Comey being called over by the president from practically behind the drapes during a ceremony. This was back in January. We now know, according to the New York Times, that Director Comey was trying to keep his distance from the president because of the ongoing Russian investigation. His discomfort in this moment that you're looking at right now would be justified some weeks later when, according to the New York Times, the president called Comey and asked him directly when federal authorities were going to put out word that he was not personally under investigation. That's just the latest item in a day that has seen many senior chefs Zelenys at the White House with more on that and more. So the video, the backstory, I mean, they're really fascinating. What else can you tell us about the New York Times reporting from this evening?
Anderson, the New York Times is continuing to report more on the backstory between what the FBI director was thinking in the moment. This is based on his recollection, very detailed, basically a journal he was keeping at the time, every time he had a meeting with the president. And Michael Schmidt at the New York Times is reporting that the FBI director just had a sense of unease about this. And our Pamela Brown reported this yesterday, that the FBI director was really, leery of talking to the president. He said on more than one occasion that the president should reach out to the Justice Department. Don't call him directly. But it's clear, Anderson, that the president was, and perhaps still is, obsessed about the notion that of him being square in the middle of this Russia investigation. Of course, when he was firing the FBI director just last week, he said that I've been assured three times that he is not the target of the investigation. But we're simply not sure if that's accurate yet. But going forward, it's just so clear that the president wanted his FBI director to be his man. It's clear the FBI director was his own man, Anderson.
And today's been nonstop for the president. Hours ago, he held a news conference where he discussed Russia for the first time since Special Counsel Mueller has been named. Give us some details.
Well, Anderson, the president has been fuming ever since he was told last night that this special counsel was happening. Again, he wasn't asked about it. He was told about it. And, you know, it's one of the sort of limits of the president's authority. But that carried over this morning, of course. He called it a witch hunt. But in his news conference this afternoon, he was fuming and seething. But he was also clearly trying to restrain his words when he was talking about Russia. Let's watch.
Because believe me, there's no collusion. Russia is fine. But whether it's Russia or anybody else, my total priority, believe me, is the United States of America. So thank you very much. There was no collusion. And everybody, even my enemies, have said there is no collusion.
So again, the president, once again, they're doing something he's done before, trying to exonerate himself, saying even my enemies have said there's no collusion. Anderson, that's what this investigation is all about. You'll hear Democrats and Republicans say there's no evidence of it necessarily, but that's what they are looking into. And the FBI director himself said before he was fired that that's why this is a serious investigation. So every time the White House has tried to diminish this, the Justice Department said, no, it's a serious investigation. And Anderson, we're left at the end of all this, 4 months after taking office, almost exactly, the president has now exactly what he didn't want at all, a special counsel looking into this Russia investigation from the very beginning. Will it find anything? We don't know if it will or not. Important to point out, we do not know that. But we do know this. It's hijacked his agenda. It's infuriated Republicans. And it's leaving him on uneven footing as he begins to step onto the world stage tomorrow, flying to Saudi Arabia, four other places over 8 days. And he is agitated by this. So that is what his mindset is tonight, Anderson.
Is there any plan in the White House to try to get the president to stop continuing to talk about the special counsel and to maybe talk about his legislative agenda and to try to kind of use this as an opportunity to move forward?
I think we could hear the beginnings of a pivot of that at that news conference today, talking about jobs, talking about how he wants to do things for America, for the voters who elected him. But all of those efforts always seem to be a ground back to a ground zero, if you will, because he tweets something like his tweet this morning. His staff was not expecting that, calling it a witch hunt. They had taken a very measured approach to all of this. So it's his impulsive nature to comment on this. And Anderson, I think that is the question going forward here. As this whole special investigation unfolds, will he have the discipline to not comment on it in real time, on a newspaper story, on a news account? Will he be able to help himself? His advisors hope he will. I think it's very much an open question.
All right, Jeff Delaney, thanks very much.